morning, children. This is 7th July English video session for class 10. I'm continuing with the poem How to Tell Wild Animals. We completed the poetry reading. By this time, you would have read the poem at least 2 to 3 times in order. You would have written the poem in the notebook. You would have written the meanings, the summary points, and now about the author, and now the critical appreciation. Okay? In the critical appreciation, first and foremost point is, what is the type of poem? What is the type of humor? Through humor, you are the poet is trying to say something. And then, she lists animals one by one. She is listing the animals. Then their characteristic features. What does it imply? Clear? Shall we continue? Yes. It is a humorous poem written for children about the wild animals. So basically, animals to children. So message also is hidden. The poem has talked about the various characteristics of wild animals. She had discussed the grandeur. Did you see the Bengal tiger? Grandeur. Beautiful. The way it sits. Our country's, precious thing is that Bengal tiger. Asian lion and Bengal tiger, they are considered as great, is it not? Most important, species of in our country. Carolyn Wells is trying to bring out the ferocity. What's ferocity? These animals are not for their wildness and anger. Ferocity of the wild animal, lion, the tiger. Great contrast to the cow, a domesticating animal. Yes. She has also pointed out the wicked nature of crocodile. What sort of a nature? Crocodile, you remember, lion's ear, like it weeps when it is eating its prey. Yes. So it's a wicked nature. This can also be associated to the mean nature of some human beings. That is what. Through animals, Carolyn tries to tell about the various nature human beings portray. Okay, where how they exhibit their features, characteristic features. So, lion, tiger, leopard. Wickedness of the crocodile. She associates them with the mean. What is this M-E-A-N? You see the last sentence? Mean nature. What is the meaning of mean nature? The very low level of thinking. It's not the proper way to judge, analysis, opinion. No. Mean is bad way, lower way, not in a decent manner, a mean way of some human beings. Okay, have you finished writing it? Please write them. You need to have this in your notebook. Okay, shall we go? No. The poet tried to portray how animals possess human. humanistic qualities. A crocodile is capable of showing posture and mug and eat, whereas the hyena smiles at you. The bear has a compassionate side and gives you a warm hug. Look at what the author is trying to say. Portrait versus animal, the poet tries to portray how animals possess humanistic qualities. Crocodile is shedding tears, hyena smiles, bear hugs. Is the real nature of animals. But these are the qualities which human beings have, and he compares them with these ways also. When does the crocodile cry? While it is eating its prey. It's not true. False tears. It's not truly, it is not feeling bad. It's false tears. Hyena smiles at you. Is it to care for you? So it's only to attack you next. Bear to hug you is to kill you. Okay, it is a simple poem written in appreciation of wild animals. Okay, in appreciation of wild animals. Please write at the top theme. The theme of the poem is simple, where the poet has tried to discuss the qualities of various wild animals and how these qualities, see children, see the word quality, quality is nature. Okay, qualities are somehow like humanistic quality. One side you have humanistic quality, another side animalistic qualities. But Caroline says the animals possess these humanistic characters. They hug only to kill. They smile only to attack. Who is that? And next, crocodile. It says it sheds only false tears. So it's all the what to say, the mean ways. Okay, the very low ways human beings try to, some human beings, when they try to behave. This is what she is trying to tell through her poem to the children. For many minutes. Pause.
Start.
Yeah. Now children, it's time you start opening your mouth and repeating each word which I say 3 times loudly. Okay? It is lent me your ears. You have to repeat it loudly. You are sitting in your house. You are comfortable. There is no disturbance. But don't make a mess in the house. Okay? Tell it correctly how it is pronounced. Roaming. 3 times. Tawny. Beast. Strolling. Peppered. Leopard. Camels. The wise. Wise. Anything which you are new to. It's the wise. And the wise handling the camera. And the wise handling the high-tech computers. Hyena. Repeat it right back 3 times. Don't feel shy. Tell it loudly. discern. See? Discern. And now you have to write the question answer session. Right at the top, question and answers. Okay, shall we start? Write the question. Does dying, see, G is missing. Okay, because of the rhyming scheme of the poem, some words will be missing. Okay, you should not write like that. The poem has the license to write like that, but you should not do it. Does dying really rhyme with the word line? Can you say it in such a way that it does? Dying, line. Dying doesn't really rhyme with line. There is no connection. However, if we say it in that manner, we can rhyme it with line. I. Is it not? Dying, line. Dying, line. So the I's are same. We can rhyme it with line. It is only through pronouncing the two words in a similar manner. Only if you pronounce it both ways, it will get it like that. Okay? Shall we go to the next question? Please write them. I'll give you time. By this, today's English video session is over. Make sure that you complete question 2 and answer. And we shall see some more.